much. Chairs, distinguished guests, and good friends. First of all, let me express my warm congratulations to the partners who are celebrating 25 years of successful cooperation. Through these 25 years, you have provided students with new and exciting opportunities. During 25 years, you have made lasting partnerships between people, businesses and universities in Russia and Norway. These partnerships are not only important for the county of Nordland and the Leningrad region, these partnerships are also a vital element in building close and neighborly relations between Norway and Russia as nations. Often we speak about cooperation between countries, we tend to look at the capitals and the national level. The national level is of course significant for relationships between countries. However, regional and local cross-border cooperation involves more people, is often more concrete and no less important. In my view, it complements the national level in many ways. The regional and local level is even more essential when we talk about neighboring countries like Russia and Norway. This is something we have clearly seen in the Barents cooperation and how important the regional cooperation has been in order to establish and maintain cross-border relations, people to people, between our two countries. And I also mean that the cooperation between Nordland County and the Leningrad Oblast, which Mr. Nurvoll mentioned, will be celebrating our 30th anniversary next year, is a good example of how important regional cooperation is. Norway and Russia have a long history of cooperation. It has been especially important for the people living in the north, but during the last 10 to 15 years, the opportunities which lie in the north have become even more evident to the rest of our country, countrymen as well. We who live in the north have of course known this for a long time. But these rich natural resources and the climate changes has made the global community look to the north in general and to the Arctic especially. This new national and international attention has been taken into account when we look at the work we have been doing for the 25 years that has passed, and now when we are discussing how can we develop it further in the years to come. Chairs, at the national level, the cooperation between Russia and Norway has been reduced since the annexation of Crimea and Russia's actions in the eastern Ukraine. Despite the fact that Norway disagreed with Russia's actions, both nations agreed that the Arctic must be kept a soul of peace and international cooperation. In times when the cooperation on a national level is reduced, I strongly believe it becomes even more important to continue the dialogue and cooperation on a regional and local level. The everyday contacts and cooperation between universities, between schools and between NGOs in our countries should continue. We must keep the channels open. As neighbors in the north, we have continued the cross-border cooperation in a number of areas, as for instance the coast guard cooperation in order to secure safety at sea and fish stock management. This year, we are also celebrating the 30th anniversary of the successful cooperation in the Arctic Council. I'm pleased to note that all the Arctic states so clearly have stated that they will prevent spillover effects from disagreement elsewhere in the world into the Arctic cooperation. Let us move on to the more concrete part of our cooperation and why we are here celebrating today. I will confess immediately that I'm a big fan of exchange programs, especially between countries in the north. Russia and Norway are countries with strong Norwegian identities. Consequently, student exchange is even more beneficial since we are sharing many of the same values as well as some of the same challenges. I believe that student exchange can strengthen the Norwegian identity and shared community of students who share and learn new skills which are directly relevant for their further studies and work in their home communities. Student exchange programs to reduce networks that become new partnerships in business and in life and are an efficient education and training capacity resources. Student exchange is also an important factor for increasing innovation and ensuring common social, economic and environmental high standards in doing businesses and accessing natural resources. We need to find ways to further stimulate Arctic student exchange, continue to learn from each other and together promote prosperous development in our countries. The Arctic Parliamentary Cooperation wants to put cooperation in education and research higher on the Arctic agenda. We have proposed to establish a circular mobility program. I believe our governments must set aside more money to encourage and facilitate student exchange between the Arctic countries. Many institutions can learn a lot and let themselves be inspired of what you have achieved for the last 25 years. Friends, the North is an area of new opportunities, including economic opportunities. It must be an area of opportunities for the people living there. We must avoid a situation, and if I should put it bluntly, where people from the South come, take out resources, ship them out, and let us live with the consequences, with little or no gain for local population. The foundation to avoid this situation is to strengthen education and research. More knowledge about the North, in the North, for the people living in the North. The Arctic Parliamentary Cooperation strongly supports capacity building, particularly through education, to ensure that local communities in the North will benefit from economic development. It is, however, vital that the capacity development is rooted in and relevant for the people living in the region, and that there are a link between the economic opportunities and the education system. Knowledge and technological innovations are keys to prosperous and sustainable development in the Arctic. We need new technology to be able to give modern societies access to healthcare, energy and more. Innovation in the Arctic must be an area of Arctic cooperation that links universities, the business sector and the political society with the knowledge and capabilities of the local populations. We need to address Arctic innovation beyond the development of natural resources. What will the people in the Arctic live off in addition to the rich natural resources? How do we stimulate innovation in the Arctic which addresses the needs of the future Arctic societies? The foundation for meeting these challenges in the future is education and research. Cooperation in this area strengthens innovation and efficiency. Dear friends, 20 years of cooperation shows that this is a serious relationship. It shows that you are a partner who will not run away when you meet difficulties. During the 25 years, you have built trust, and trust is the most important and valuable basis for the next 25 years. I look forward to the next 25 years and to our continued efforts maintaining a vital and prosperous love. I wish you all the best for the future.